in a nursery with a lot of head scab. Here's a road that has a lot of head scab.
My.
This is a very susceptible wheat line. Here you can see these heads. A head with only a little scab might look like this. So this head only has two spikelets that are bleached out. This one here, and I turn it around, and this one here. The rest of the head is all green still. This is really diagnostic of scab. If you see this head, for example, here, from the initial infection, which might have been here, or here, or here, the disease has spread through the head, through the central stem, and now it's infecting other spikelets up and down that stem. So if you see heads that are partly green and partly bleached out, tan colored, that is very likely to be scab. See this pink color on these spikelets? The fungus is reproducing here. These are more spores of the Fusarium fungus. And when you see this pink color, it's a good way to confirm that you're really looking at head scab and not some other cause of bleaching in the heads. So by the time you see these symptoms, the bleaching of parts of the wheat heads, the disease has already developed past the point where you can take any measures to control it. These infections occurred at flowering about 3 weeks ago. So it's important to keep track of the weather leading up to flowering, during flowering, and just after flowering, because rain and warm temperatures will lead to infections of this disease, Fusarium head blight. It's at flowering that you can spray a fungicide if your risk for scab is elevated. And the most effective fungicides are the triazoles, Prosaro, Proline, and Caramba. You want to stay away from strobilurin fungicides applied at flowering to control scab because they can actually make the problem worse. The fungicide has to be applied within a narrow time frame in order to give you 50% control. And that time frame is early flowering to mid-flowering. And application by ground is more effective than by air. And the nozzles should be angled at 45 degrees in order to drive the product into the wheat heads. So here's wheat that is very heavily affected by head scab. When you're looking at a field of wheat, if you have at least 10% of the spikelets that are bleached out like this from scab, then you're likely to have a problem at harvest with tombstones, which are shriveled grains, with kernel abortion, meaning you didn't even get a kernel at that spot in the head, and certainly with the mycotoxin called DON or deoxynivalenol. So if at least 10% of your spikelets are bleached like this, you want to turn up the fan speed in your combine to blow those lightweight kernels out the back, because those lightweight kernels are the ones with the most mycotoxin, DON, in them. You can have your wheat tested for DON, the mycotoxin, before you take it to market, and that'll give you an idea if you've got a problem. Levels of mycotoxin or DON above 2 parts per million may make your wheat unfit for human consumption, and levels above 5 or 10 parts per million may make it unfit for animal consumption. So those will be the limits that some purchasers of grain will be testing for and looking for. So if it's a wet spring and conditions are warm and moist leading up to flowering, then your risk of scab may be elevated. The way you can find that out is by using the scab risk forecasting site. And you can go to ScabSmart or to the North Carolina Small Grains Production website for a link to the scab risk map. Now that risk map, if you click on your area, will give you a sense of how severe your scab risk is for wheat flowering at the date that you say that it's flowering at. If your risk is moderate to severe, then we recommend application of a fungicide. The best scab fungicides only give partial control of scab, maybe 50% of symptoms and of the mycotoxin. So it's important not to only rely on fungicide, but to also select varieties that have moderate resistance to scab. The North Carolina State University Small Grains Production website has all the information you need about sprays, pre-harvest intervals, thresholds, and application rates.
This program is funded by the North Carolina Small Grain Growers Association.